When I was maybe 11 years old, I remember very clearly going to the pediatrician and getting a vaccine. You know, the whole time I was just really tense and I was like, this doesn't hurt. And I looked the other way. I just remember standing and then I don't remember anything. And then I remember lying down and the doctor was asking me, okay, so what is your name? When were you born? I obviously lost consciousness.
Hi, my name is Jorge Corona. I'm a multimedia content producer here at NYU, but I'm also just very scared of needles in general. There have been a lot of times when I get a vaccine and I feel dizzy or I actually even faint. I want to be a good citizen though and get my COVID vaccine. So I reached out to Saribel Garcia Quiñones, a clinical associate professor at NYU's Rory Myers College of Nursing, to see if she had any tips on getting over my needle phobia.
So like you, there are many, many patients that feel extremely nervous and anxious when getting an injection. And then needle phobia may involve a more extreme response, such as a vasovagal response, which is what occurred to you. It promotes the veins to dilate, especially the ones in the legs. And when that happens, you may feel very dizzy and fainty and may even collapse and lose consciousness. So now you're scared of the needle, but now there's also even more fear that this may happen to me. I may collapse or I may faint. It is such an added effect. What I have found in my experience with all the vaccines that we give is three different types of responses. The first group, thankfully the most common, really, really, really wants to be immunized. They want every vaccine that they can get to protect them from getting sick. Then a smaller group really fear the vaccine, what's in the vaccine, what the vaccine can do to them. They don't so much fear the disease that it is protecting them from. And then there's the third group, also a smaller group. This group really has such a fear of the actual injection. They avoid vaccines at all costs. They may also fear the disease and they wish they could get vaccinated, but they avoid it. The best way to manage a vasovagal response is prevention. Laying down and elevating the legs prior to and even during the injection helps to prevent you from fainting. And then staying in that position for a few minutes after the injection also helps your body to recover from the experience. Distraction is another really important thing. Lowers the distress, listening to music, even just talking to your provider or talking to someone maybe that went with you. But there is a good amount of evidence that suggests that visiting a therapist that specializes in cognitive behavioral therapy may help, not just for this year's vaccine, for the years to come as well.
So maybe next time I put on The Godfather on my Netflix app and then just wait for the right moment.
That sounds like a big distraction. Yes.
Yeah, I'll ask.
I didn't actually watch The Godfather because I didn't want to be too cool, but I did put my feet up like Professor Quiñones suggested. No fainting, COVID immunity. Good work, science.